So in this lecture, we'll see about path delay optimization. And this topic can also be, you know, called as buffer insertion. You will understand why we call it as buffer insertion, you know, in some time. So what we have done so far is we have actually, defined certain terms like logical effort, electrical effort, and all these things. And we have figured out if you are given a path with logic gates and if their inputs are specified and sizes are specified, or their input and load capacitances are specified for each of the gate in the path, then you can actually estimate the total path delay. Okay, so let's take the same example that we had done. We had a NOT gate and an odd NOR gate and a NAND gate and a NOT gate again. Okay, and this NOR was 2 input, NAND was 3 input, and NOT again is, you know, single input anyway. Okay, we had the input here, right, and we specified the capacitances. Okay, as I said, you can specify the sizes of the gates or the capacitances. If both are known, that is also okay, but they should be consistent. Okay, so you had one capacitance at the input side of this inverter, and the input of the NOR will have another capacitance. And remember, these capacitances that I am drawing at the input of every gate is only the input strength of each gate. Okay, it's not the parasitic of the previous gate, it's only the input capacitance of each of the gate. Okay, that is what we are mentioning here, right? Similarly, there is a capacitor here and there's a capacitor here, and finally you will be driving a load, right? So let's call this CL. And for a change, and for the usefulness of the discussion that we are going to have in the remaining part of the lecture, let me call these gates as GX, GY, GZ instead of Z1, Z2, Z2, Z3 that we had done earlier. Okay, and these capacitances correspondingly call CX, CY, CZ. Okay, and let's call this C1. Okay, just a naming convention that will be useful for me while defining the rest of the contents of the lecture. Okay, and since I've specified the capacitances, I will not specify the gate. I need not actually specify the gate sizes, but just for the discussion purpose, let me specify this is unit size inverter, size 1 inverter, okay, which is a gate 1. Okay, gate 1 is size 1 inverter, and input capacitance of the gate 1 is C1, which is obviously 3C, because it's size 1, I know it should be 3C only. Okay, and you have a load, right? Now, say for example, I tell you that to calculate the path delay, we know how to do it, we have done it the same example multiple times. Okay, and the point is that, say if say if this load capacitance is somewhere around 5000 times the input capacitance of this gate. Okay, 5000 times 3C, which is 15000C. Okay, let me say my load capacitance is very high, like this. Okay, 5000 times that of the input capacitance. So the electrical effort of this particular gate would be CL by 3C, which is around 5000, right? So let me say my delay up to these three gates is delay XYZ. Okay, I know how to calculate it, we have done it also earlier. Okay, and let me say now this delay alone, okay, is D1. Let's say this is D1. Okay, so I know the total delay is DXYZ. DXYZ is essentially DX plus DY plus DZ, right? And DXYZ plus D1 is the total delay, that much I know. Okay, And I know that, you know, it's easy to calculate. We can calculate it given the capacitance values, and it will be obviously dependent on each of these capacitances, and they are not going to be very large because the gate sizes, if I specify the gate sizes, I know how to calculate capacitances, then they will not be very large if the gate sizes are somewhere around 1, 2, 3, and so on like that. Okay. Now, here the problem is that the load capacitance that the whole path is going to drive at the end is very, very large. That is the problem that I'm telling you, and it is a realistic problem. Okay, in a sense, say for example, you have a chip, and this is the logic that is going to be executed, okay, in the chip, and then finally at the end of the chip you have, I mean, at the end of the circuit, this particular pin, okay, from the chip. Say for example, this is the logic, and this logic should be the output of this logic should be supplied to another chip. Okay, so you have a chip like this here, chip one, and say it has multiple pins like this. Okay, three pins this side, three pins this side. Okay, now you have another chip two, and it has like two pins, say like this. Now it so happens that the one, two, three, let's say the second pin is implementing this logic. Okay, I mean, this logic is being constructed as a circuit in this chip. It's an IC, right? In this IC, this logic is being constructed, and this output point is being connected to this particular second pin, and this second pin should go and drive this first pin. Okay, and whatever the logic is there available here, that will be and along with this particular line, along with this wire, okay, it's going to contribute the load capacitor CL. Okay, whatever it sees as the, you know, whatever this pin 2 is going to drive on the chip 2, along with the load capacitor will offer some kind of a, along with the wire will offer some kind of a load capacitor, right? And this capacitance or off-chip capacitances can always be very, very large. Okay, this is a realistic situation. This is not some hypothetical case. So on inside chip there can be smaller capacitances, but off chip capacitances, when you are going to drive the signal from one chip to other, you can encounter off chip capacitances that might be of the order what we have mentioned here. Okay, it can be of nanofarads also, because you know we know on chip capacitors are somewhere around you know femtofarads or so, but then you can encounter cases that are several hundreds of picofarads or even nanofarads off chip. Okay, so this is a realistic situation. In those case, in that cases, let us see what happens to the delay. Okay, so I, you know, these DXYZ, the gates XYZ are on chip, and the capacitance is also on chip, so they might not be very large. So the delay incurred by DXYZ, that delay, okay, that will not be very large. But since your gate one, the last gate, okay, which is going to drive a large capacitor CL, its delay might be comparatively larger than DXYZ. So it is, it makes sense to analyze D1 separately. Okay, and finally it's going to add to DXYZ. So let me analyze D1 separately, and let me say this is fixed. Okay, this is not going to change. So if I see, if I want to know what is D1, D1 is nothing but the parasitic effort times logical effort into electrical effort, right? Parasitic effort is 1 for inverter, logical effort is 1 again for inverter, and then electrical effort is how big is my load compared to myself. And I said this is of size 1 gate, so its capacitance 3C. So 5000 times 3C is the load, so 5000 will be my electrical effort. So it's approximately 5000. Okay, 5000 is essentially the 5000 is essentially your delay. Okay, 5000 is the normalized delay, and if I will multiply this by tau, which is 3 RC, to get the actual delay.